Morning, this is Dana. Boy, it's good to be back home. I really had a great time with the grandkids, but it's always good to be home. So if you're here, give me lots of love, lots of hearts. I'm so glad to see you. And today we're going to talk about a very important topic, and that is prejudging. Now, none of us want to be judgmental, and we don't want to judge people. I know that most of us are saying, no, that's not a good habit to have. But I think when it comes to our business, sometimes we make some judgments before we actually offer or before we invite. Don't you agree? I think sometimes what we do is we say, you know, she wouldn't want to do my business because she already has a job. You know what? She probably is too busy. Or, you know, here's one that I think is really, really big, is that we only begin to sponsor people who are below us in our mind instead of everyone. Now, let me give you a really good example. When I first started out in the business, everybody on my team, I was 26, everybody on my team was under 26. And my mentor, who I loved, said to me, you know, Dana, you need to expand and invite everybody, because subconsciously, I was inviting those people that I thought I could lead easily. And I wasn't even aware that I was doing it. I was just looking for people who I felt like, okay, I could lead her, I could lead that person. And so I think sometimes we have to be much more intentional about finding people, everyone, and seeing everyone as a potential lead, as a potential client, as a potential host. So I think that's really important. So for example, I think one of the big part of the population that we forget is those people who are trying to supplement their retirement income, because there are lots and lots of people that you might think, oh, well, she probably doesn't want to work. She's, you know, this age, and they could use that extra flexible part-time business, but we don't invite them. We don't ask them because, oh, you know, we prejudge. Or maybe the person who already has and appears to have a really significant income. You know, I know this is true. Some of you are recruiting the needy and not the greedy. Now, I'm not saying just recruit the greedy, but I'm saying everyone has needs. In fact, what I did today is I made a little game, and it's a match game. Do you remember when you were in kindergarten and you had to draw a line from one to the other, from the words to the picture? Well, that's what this one is. So the stay-at-home mom of teenagers, what might be her reason other than money? What might be her reason? So you can look over on the side and say, oh, maybe she wants a fun job. Maybe she needs the respect of her children. So there are lots of reasons that people join our business. Lots of reasons people buy our club. I'm glad you love this. Yay. If you love it, hashtag match. Hashtag match, and I'll send you the match game today. So I just really believe that what we want to do is think about all of the reasons that people join our business. You know, they come for the flexibility. They come for the fun. Sometimes you've had people, I know one gal who's a nurse practitioner, and this is her fun job. And because being a nurse practitioner is very intense, and she can make some extra money, but go out and see some girls and have fun and not make it a life or death decision. They come for the friendship. You know, there are lots of people who have lots of money that may not have the friendships and close relationships. So remember to be intentional. Obviously, there are needs to be met that are financial needs, and that is something important. But also, there are a whole bunch of other reasons that people might join your business or might be one of your clients, your customers, or your hosts. So I want you to think about that and not prejudge. Now, if you love this, if you are like, oh, okay, this is speaking to me, I want you to be intentional about looking around and thinking, maybe there are some people who are higher than you in the economic strata. Maybe there are some people who are at the same, but you think, oh, well, they've got it made. Maybe you don't know that they're struggling to make their house payment. I want you to look around you in terms of not just people who are like you, but people who are different than you. Now, let me tell you this great story. Remember, I told you she told me to go out and find some people. Now, I didn't know at the time, because I was 26. She was in her mid-40s. You know, she seemed old to me. Oh, my gosh. Now I'm thinking that's crazy. But anyway, so I called her. I was so excited to go, oh, Jane, I got an old one. She's 46. And Jane just laughed, you know, because she was such a great mentor, and said, well, that's great, Dan. That's really good. And I'll tell you what, Aggie was one of my very, very, very best consultant's best team members for a number of years because she was just steady and she didn't have a bunch of little kids running around, and she enjoyed getting out and being with people. And you know what? She made great income, but she didn't actually need the income, but she sure didn't turn it down. There are people out there that are coming in and into your businesses because they want to make a philanthropic difference. You know, one of our clients supports an orphanage in Africa, and you know the orphanage has her name on it because she gives, and that's what she does with her money. So I just think it's really important for us to remember, don't judge before. That's prejudging. Don't judge before, oh, this person wouldn't. You have nothing to lose by inviting them to hear about your company. You have nothing to lose just to ask them if they have, don't ask them if they're interested. Oh my gosh, that makes me crazy because nobody's interested. They don't come in going, oh, you know, when I'm 7 years old, I think I want to sell this when I grow up. No, people don't know about your opportunity. They don't know about your company. And many of them have misconceptions about direct selling and about MLMs. So I stop asking if they're interested and start saying, I don't know if you're interested or not. More on that next week. I love you. I've gone a little long this time. #match. Talk to you later. Bye.